Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in today's session we are going to design a one-way slab. Okay, so here is some criteria I have written down or a given data which I have written down. You can see FCK is equals to 20 Newton per mm square, where Fy is 415 Newton per mm square. Live load which is given as 3 kilo Newton per meter square. Okay, so floor finish, this is nothing but a floor finish which is given as 1 kilonewton per meter square. Width of support on which your slab is resting, okay, so that is 300 mm. Okay, assuming this case as a simply supported case. Okay, I am assuming this case as a simply supported case. Okay, so room dimensions, that is the clear room dimensions which are inner, is 5 meter by 2 meter. So this is a given data which I have. So based upon this, I am going to design now a singly reinforced, or you can say, sorry, the word is wrong. Actually, we want to design a one-way slab which is simply supported. Okay, so that is what is the case. So the very first step, okay, so the very first step is to determine whether this case is one-way case or two-way. First of all, we need to know that. So this step one is nothing but determination of slab type, we can say. Okay, so how we can design? So Ly will be here, your Ly will be 5 meter. Okay, so my Ly will be 5 meter and Lx will be 2 meter. Okay, so Lx will be 2 meter. So the case is how we are going to design it, that is the ratio of Ly by Lx, which is 5 by 2, which comes approximately like 2.5. okay, and this 2.5, which is greater than 2, you have to compare this value with 2. Okay, so if it is greater than 2, this case is belonging to the one-way slab design, or you can say this case or this slab is a one-way slab. What this? So this is the very first step we have to know. The second important step is, okay, so the second step is you have to calculate the effective depth. Okay, so depth we have to calculate. So we can write down this next step as depth calculation. So how I am going to assume the depth, or how I am going to consider the depth of my slab? So I have one formula for this, or I have one criteria for this, which is given by the IS code. That is from the criteria of, you can say, the deflection. The check for deflection which we are using in case of one-way slab or simply supported case, that check for deflection case we can consider here to calculate the effective depth. So I can written down this formula as D is equals to L by 20. So this 20 is constant. So if the case is simply supported, we have to assume this value as 20. If it is a continuous beam, the case will be different, or continuous beam, continuous slab, the case will be a different one. If it is a cantilever slab, the case will be a different one. Okay, so L by 20. So approximately, now you have to consider this L is nothing but Lx. So 2000 is my Lx divided by this 20, 100 mm approximately my depth is coming across 100 mm. So this is what is the depth I have to consider here. So now this is nothing but your effective depth. So overall depth is equals to D plus D dash, that is cover. So 100 plus 25, that is 125 mm, will be my effective depth. Okay, so the third important step is effective span. because effective span is also one of the important parameter which we need to consider. So how we are going to consider or how we are going to calculate this effective span? So there is one consideration which is given in the IS code that is same as that of your singly reinforced beam. So that is nothing but L effective is equals to clear dimensions, that is the center to center distance between the supports. Okay, so that is your span, that is L plus B by 2 plus B by 2, that is 2 plus 0.3 by 2 plus 0.3 by 2, that is 2.3 meter. Okay, second case is L plus D, that is small d or effective depth, and this is nothing but 2 plus 0.1 is equals to 2.1 meter. You have to consider whichever is the less. So less is 2.1 meter. So L effective we have to consider as 2.1 meter. Okay. So rest calculation is about, you can say, the load calculation. Okay, you have to also consider the self weight of slab. Okay, so I will write down the self weight of slab as, or you can write here, either you can write here as dead load, okay, which will be the same. So the formula begins B into D into rho of concrete. So now here B is your 1, because we are considering this case for the 1 meter width or 1 meter unit strip. 1 into, okay, so this case is as 1 into D is nothing but the depth, and depth is overall depth. So overall depth you have to consider as 0.125 into 25 will be the density of concrete. So multiplying these things you will get an value. Okay, so this value is nothing but 3.125 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, so this is also kilonewton per meter square. So next is the thing that we have to consider, the live load coming on the slab, that is we have considered as 3 kilonewton per meter square, which has been given in the given data. Floor finish is like 1 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, so by adding all these things above, you will get 3.125 plus 3 plus 1. Approximately this value comes out to be 3 plus 3, 6 plus 1, 7. 7.125 kilonewton per meter square is exactly the value you have to consider for the calculation. Okay, so 7.125 kilonewton per meter square, this is the outcome which you have to consider. Okay, so next part is, you can directly now move towards the part that is moment calculation. Okay, so bending moment. So this is your fifth step, bending moment. Okay, so here you can calculate this bending moment as mu is equals to wu le square divided by 8. Le is L effective and wu is nothing but your ultimate load multiplied by factor of safety 1.5. So this ultimate load, actually I forgot to calculate this, because here you need to calculate that. So first, if you multiply this here itself, 1.5 into 7.125, this value comes out to be 10.68 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, so this is what is the value of Wu which you have to put here, that is 10.68 into L effective is 2.1 square divided by 8. This value comes out to be 5.88 kilonewton meter. okay. So in this way you can calculate the bending moment. So this is a calculated bending moment. So this bending moment is a calculated one, okay. So if you want to cross check it, you can cross check it by using one formula, that is mu limit is equals to 0.138 fckbd square for the grade of steel when it is Fe415, that time this constant is 0.138. So if I will do in this way, d under root mu divided by, you can put here mu as your calculated bending moment, okay, and 0.138 fckb. If you'll put all these things here in this formula, that is mu is nothing but 5.88 into 10 raised to 6 divided by 0.138 into 20 is your grade of concrete and b is nothing but unit width you have to consider because it is a slab, okay. So in case of slab we consider in that way. So whatever may be the depth is, you have to calculate. So by calculation this depth comes out to be 46.19 mm. So you know, as per our calculation, the depth we have assumed, that was, that is effective depth 100 mm, okay. So depth we provided, so provided depth is greater than the required depth, okay, and hence you are safe, okay, you are safe in bending moment. So one criteria is over now. So now we can move towards the next formula, that is the sixth step, okay. This is your sixth step, and which is, you can see, area of steel, okay. So this is your area of steel, as you know the formula, and this is your main steel. Do remember, while we are designing the slab, there are two types of steel, main steel and distribution steel. So main steel we have to calculate by the normal formula, AST main I will write it as, that is the normal formula, as we know, 0.5 fck divided by fy in bracket 1 minus under root 4.6 mu divided by fck bd square bracket close into bd. This is what is the formula you have to consider for this, okay. So now the next step will be, you have to put all the values in this particular formula, okay. 415, 1 minus under root 1 minus 4.6 in bracket 4.88 into 10 raised to 6 divided by fck is 20 into 1000 is your unit width, d is 100 square as it is your effective depth. So the next part is 1000 into 100, 1000 into 100, okay. So this is what is the formula. So now your value of AST Dickens 168 mm square. So this is your 168 mm square. So this is your area of AST main, you can call it as. So okay, this is main steel. Now distribution steel also we will calculate, but before that we will finalize the provided steel, because this is the formula which is used for the required steel. This much amount is required, so how much you are going to provide, that also you have to consider. So for this, if I am assuming, or if I am just assume that you are providing, okay, provide 8 mm diameter bars for main steel, suppose, okay. So we have to calculate the spacing, okay. So we have to calculate the spacing of main bar, okay. Spacing of main bar, the formula for spacing of main bar will be area of one bar, that is area of this 8 mm diameter bar, divided by AST required into 100 into 1000, that is width, unit width, okay. So this is normally 50.28, this is area of one bar is 50.28 divided by area of steel required is 168 and into 1000, okay. So this comes out to be 299.19 mm. Okay, so normally this spacing we have to assume it as a lesser one. Why we are assuming it as a lesser one? Because men's steel we have to provide. Okay, so if you want to provide the distribution steel, so the formula for calculating distribution steel will be, you can call it as ASTD, is 0.12% of BD. Okay, 0.12% of BD. When 0.12? When it will be your HYSD bar or Torr steel. And when it is mild steel, 0.15 you have to consider instead of 0.12%. Okay, so 0.12 divided by 100 into 1000 into 125, because 125 is your you can say the total depth, that is overall depth. Okay, so the final outcome is 150 mm square. Okay, so this is what is the required. Again, you have to calculate the same things. That is, first of all, you will provide some bar. I am providing 8 mm diameter bar again, because area is very much less. So you can assume bars of lesser diameter. So 8 mm diameter bars. Okay, so spacing for this particular bar is, again, spacing is equals to the same formula, area of one bar divided by AST into your 1000 width. Okay, so area of one bar is 50.28 approximately, and then divided by 150 into 1000. Okay, so this value comes out to be 335.06. This is quite more. So provide distribution steel of 8 mm diameter bar, okay, at 300 mm center to center. Okay, so the final step is now provided area of steel. How you can calculate provided area of steel? Okay, so the same formula you have to use again, that is 50.28 or 50.26, something like that. Okay, so divided by 300, whatever the spacing you have assumed, that you have to consider here, and into 1000. So the final outcome becomes 167.53 mm square. Okay, so this is what is your final outcome. This is the provided steel. Okay, and this is also your provided steel. This is the final outcome. Okay, so in this way you can calculate the main steel and distribution steel, and you can check you can take check for bending moment by using the formula of MU limiting. So this was all about the design of one-way slab. In next session we are going to discuss many more things related to design again. Okay, so stay tuned with my videos, and I hope you guys got some good knowledge in today's session as well. So if you like my video, please like, share and subscribe. Okay, so thank you guys.